Welcome to my class, the theory of structure, and congratulations, all of you have passed the mechanics of material, and some may get the A, some may get the D dog. If you get the D dog, don't worry, you still have chance to develop yourself. Okay, please take it. Who get the A, the B plus, please keeping it. Okay, let me move to the course of theory of structure. Again, I'm Sithichai Sangathit, and you may email me if you have some question. Most of the time I respond the email, and then there is the book you're supposed to use. This it's going to be the structural analysis from Professor Hiberer. Yeah, you may make a copy after the class. Okay, I will provide you, and you should not disturb you. Okay, out of SUT, is going to be illegal. And then there are things that you supposed to understand before we start the class again, why we study these courses. Okay, the problem of that start with the objective of this one. We like you to understand the concept of theory and the method of analysis of three-dimensional structural, including again truss beam frame. You have truss beam frame in static, and then two more on the arches and the cable. Okay, and then you recognize the limit assumption used to develop the theory and the method. Again, the big picture is the force act on the structure. The structure should have the linear elastic behavior with small deformation. That is too big assumption. And then there are specific assumption for the truss. The truss joined by the frictionless pin and the load applied to the joints. So the member of the truss will subjected to the two forces. Okay, that's going to be tension or compression. For the beam subject mostly by the shear force and the bending. And then we determine the deflection of the beam, right? And the deflection caused by the movement and the effect of the shear force is really small, negligible. Those kind of things are the assumption for some specific structure. I will mention that later. And then after you get the solution, you got to have some engineering sense for the beam from the final examination of the mechanics of material. If you get 1 meter deflection, that's wrong for sure. Okay, the free friction is supposed to be really small, right? L over 240 or L over 360, around that, not too much larger than that. Okay, that's main thing. We're going to develop everything from objective 1, 2, 3. We're gonna develop engineering sense and engineering judgment. Now, talking about this class, actually, we have the Facebook, everything working to post over here. And also, if you dig down into the Facebook, there are all information and most of what Ajahn lecturing you very close to that. Okay, so someone who very active on this can go to the deeps of the Facebook group. You will get many, many information. Now, based on the objective, okay, we're going to have the real world problem. This one won't be constructed until we plan it, we analyze it, we decide it, and then we construct it. But before we construct this one, we got to use the imagine. We call it the modeling. We got to do the model. This is going to be the beam, okay? Just put it into this member, and then the beam must be fixed to the wall. Why wouldn't pin it? No, you should not pin it, because if you pin it, this one will fall down, okay? Because the pin cannot resist the moment. And then following this one, after you model it, actually you got to determine the forces most of the time อาจารย์ will provide you the force of 10 kilonewton per meter in any static this subject also most of the time อาจารย์ will provide you but the first chapter we will talking about how the forces like this one come from it's maybe come from this pile of timber it's maybe come from the brick wall okay apply to the beam it's maybe anything that's put the load onto the structure now in static you got to use the concept of free body diagram and equation of equilibrium to determine the reaction from those one you just release the structure take the support out put the reaction into it a sub x prevent the movement in the x axis a sub y the movement in the vertical and then m sub a to prevent the rotation by prevent it moving in the horizontal in the vertical and rotation okay they cause the reaction that's going to be two forces and one moment and then you may use the concept okay concept of what concept of resultant force due to distributed load resultant force equal to what 10 kilonewton per meter times 4 meter that's going to be 40 and then it's going to act at what 2 meter okay so you will get that solution and then after this one you're going to be able to determine the solution and I assign you guys to try to find the solution now you're going to have some ending sense that I said okay the reaction supposed to be in some constraint of the value from this one if you get a sub x to be some value it's going to be impossible because there is no action force in the x direction something like this one and then after you decide it okay you're going to use some adjustment there are steel section okay one going to be type a type b and type c and then you know from any static and mechanics of material this one going to be largest moment of inertia this one going to be the second this one going to be the third and section that you should use is going to be this one since all of them have the same cross sectional area okay now let me move you again to the thing going to be the paper for the foundation of the more advanced courses and then we're going to use these courses over here to take the engineering license examination okay that mean you're going to take two classes with me this term and next term and then you will take classes with Ajahn Mongkhon Ajahn Annob okay and then also soil mechanics with Ajahn I'm not sure Ajahn Virut those guy of that professor okay but this is significant because you got to have 60% at least to pass the engineering license and this is going to be one of that what's going to be included in this subject I should start with we're going to know about type of structure this one going to be the truss this one going to be the cable this one going to be the beam and then the beam connect with the column we call it what the frame yes the frame okay and then there is the computer software called SUSTRUCTURE you guys go to the link in my Facebook or go by using the Google you can download the SUSTRUCTURE developed by our first batch student that's many years ago used to be very popular in Thailand because it's very easy to use even the high school student can use the program and then we go to the second one we're going to analyze the truss and then we review again how to draw the shear bending moment diagram of the beam and the frame and then we have the examination okay after first examination we will talking about the cable and the arch. We will talking about the inference lines occur on mostly the beam, okay, and the girder, not the truss. And then after finish chapter 5, we supposed to have our second midterm examination. And then we again go to diffraction. Hey, Ajahn, we have kids in mechanics of material. That one is simple. Okay, there is various diffraction to determine of the truss of the frame, not only for the beam. Okay, and then we have many methods to calculate for the diffraction. After finish topic number 9, we have our third midterm examination. And then we move to a more complex structure called statically indeterminate structure. Now, not only the free body diagram and equation of equilibrium, we got to use what's so called compatibility condition to solve the structure. You recall that's one from chapter 4, chapter 5, right? The compatibility condition. Actually, let's call it chapter 4 most of the time. Okay, that is simple. This one is more complex because the one that we study is just the axial forces member. Okay, but this one, we're going to talking about the beam. Okay, and then after we talking about the beam, we talking about the frame, we talking about the truss, and we talking about the composite structure, which usually the combination of the beam and the truss, so kind of thing. And then we have the final examination, and you supposed to be ready for engineering license. Not yet. After you finish it, you got to use it later. Okay. Anyway, let me move to the computer program. Okay. You search by the Google, and then you supposed to have the program. The conduct of the course, again, we should have homework. And I don't think we're going to have quiz. And that's mean the homework going to be like a 10% as we have it in the mechanics of material. And then we have 1, 2, 3, 4 examination. 2 going to be in the schedule of the university, midterm and the final. But in between, we will have it by our own. And then following this one, the grade, the 80 used to be for the A, not 90, 80 is more than enough, okay? And then for the F, I should say in the mechanics of material, the F is only 40 something, okay? Not 50. That's why a lot of people pass it, okay? Because we cannot do it at 50. If we do it at 50, half of our students will get F. Anyway, you have it. And really, congratulations. I talked with our civil engineering faculty meeting. And my international civil engineering student is better than Thai student. Hey, you sure? There are some international students that didn't better than Thai. Yeah, but they can develop, I told them. Anyway, all you pass it. So you got to do better, right? Okay, okay, better, get the A. Keep the A, that's called better, okay? Then please attend the class. Actually, I going to check you, but not 80, maybe like last time, like 70% to have a final examination. And then please bring the calculator to help me during the calculation and also practice how to use the calculator also. And then homework again within 1 week. One of the students comment to me, this is too short. I said, if this is 2 weeks, you will lose everything. You won't turn in. It's 2 weeks. You forgot the lecture already, right? I think 1 week is more than enough, right? Okay. It's only once out of 100. They just keep complaining. Anyway, let's keep doing what we have usually in our real life when we work. Our boss always said, hey, that's gonna be due in 2 days, right? Hey, boss, that is too much. Why don't 7 days? Kick out of your company, right? And then cheating, I don't think my student cheat, but they're going to put it over here to give you the rules and regulation. And then the last one, if you have something happen during the examination and it's very necessary, I will give you the makeup examination. Don't worry about it. For the telephone, please keep it not turned off, just keep it quiet. And then there is two very important organizations in Thailand you guys supposed to visit. One is going to be the Engineering Institute of Thailand. That is very important professional organization in our civil engineering. And also another one is the Council of Engineers of Thailand. That's going to hold the legal document for the engineering license. The, when we have the engineering license examination, it's going to be by the Council of Engineers Thailand. And then finish the first part of this one. Any question? No question at all, right? Oh, Ajahn talking anything? I didn't get it. That's really most important, you know. The first part of this one, talking about the grade. that's the most important for the student. Now, let me start chapter one, the type of structure and loads. Okay, there are two things that's important for our occupation, the load. When the load act on the structure will resist the load and show us how it's deformed, how it resists the forces, the beam gonna be bent. Okay, something like this one. The first one, there are various type of structure I already mentioned. We will go past it very quick to understand various type of structure. And I will talk about something about the truss already. Truss made by stress member joint by the pin, the load applied at the joint. The member of the truss is two force member. If it won't be in tension, it's going to be in compassion to decide it. Use the knowledge from chapter 1, chapter 2, chapter 3, and chapter 4. You may decide it, right? The member. And if the member of the task subject to large compassion, you got to use the concept of buckling of chapter 13, something like this one. Finish this one. And let me tell you, up until now, you guys, all of you, can design the task. The green task near the activities building, you're supposed to be able to decide it. But before you decide it, you got to expect it, estimated the load that's applied to the task by yourself. Okay, we'll be talking about that later. So type of load is important. You got to be able to determine the type of load that's applied to the green task near the activities building. If you dive back to your dormitory after the class, you will pass the task also. Now, for the engineer, we have structure. Structure is anything, okay, that's built for some intended function. It must be built to resist the estimated applied load, okay? Some of you in the future, maybe very big boss engineer, decide a missile launcher. Oh, that's going to be working in North Korea. Anyway, don't worry, okay? Or some of you guys may go to the marine industry, okay? Build very large ship. That's called the structure also. The structure can be anything, but the limit, our interest to what I'm show you, the task, the beam, the frame, the arch, and the cable for the cast over here. And now, the structure must be safe under the application of the forces in Bangkok. Okay, okay, this one in Bangkok, this one in our university, the same thing. The structure must be safe from very heavy wind load, for example, it's occur every day. No, the typhoon maybe just one or two times a year, but the structure must be safe under the action of the typhoon. Earthquake is maybe occur once in a year or once in the blue moon. But when it occur, this Tubayok Tower must be safe under the earthquake load. So estimating this kind of abnormal forces will be discussed further by Ajahn Mungkut, okay, in the course of building design. But for us, we're going to talking about the simple one. What you are learning from this course is going to be all simple thing, okay? The more difficult will be discussed later. Let me move you to many kind of structure that's previously built, okay? In our history, okay, different country have different renowned structure, pyramid, also very renowned for Egypt, okay? And then nowadays, we also very, very huge structure that's gonna call the CERN in the Europe. They build this kind of huge structure to study the origin of the universe. And I have a chance to join that about 10 years ago. Anyway, me over here. This is me. A very small one. And then I also have a chance to visit it. Yeah, let's see my face. And then you can see we when we are here, we are really small, okay, compared to the cross section of the tunnel. Okay, the tunnel is not only structural engineering for sure. It's going to be geotechnical engineering, those kind of engineer gonna work to get there over here. And for us, before we build anything, okay, simple structure such as the parking garage, or really complex structure, okay, such as what you see the link structure of the CERN, the step gonna be the same, but the detail of the step gonna be different. First, we got to plan. Okay, we going to build the garage structure to park car. We're going to build a garage structure to park a 10-wheel truck. They're going to be the same, right? No, the size of it going to be different, okay? For parking the motorcycle, it's going to be really small. You can see around here. For parking the car, okay, you can go to academic building one, okay? For parking the truck, you may go to the bus station. The structure gonna be different in size, but the concept gonna be for the function of what? Okay, you got to do the planning professionally, and on your plan, you got to set up the objective of the structure and what form of structure to be aesthetic, beautiful, okay, safe, okay, and economy. It's depend on your money. If you have a large budget, okay, you may design or plan your structure with very sophisticated thing. But if you have limited budget, okay, you got to be optimized everything. And then you got to select a proper material. You got to put the structure to work together. Okay, if you just thinking about the coverway, you may go over there. There is a cover sheet, right? And then there is a steel. Okay, to taking care of the cover sheet, one is going to be in this direction, and this one going to be curved like this one. And then for the curved one, there is the column, and there is a small foundation. The load is going to transfer from the roof sheet, the lead one, okay, to the small beam, and to the frame, to the foundation. I like you guys to think about this when from now, thinking about this one. Hey, Ajahn, that is the roof sheet. The force, the rain, the wind gonna act on the top of that similar thing, okay? And that similar thing put on what? There is the beam that's put in that direction. That's called purlin, okay? The load from the metal sheet, okay? Maybe from the wind, the weight of the metal sheet by itself, transfer to the purlin, and then what support the pyridine? Pyridine will touch, right? Yes, you can transfer the force from the roof to the pyridine to the touch. Now, which support the touch? The column. Okay, and then the force from the column gonna transfer to the foundation. That's going to be the same thing. Okay, and then that's called the structural system. Now, you got to analyze the structure from the task. You got to have this one in your mind, but the model gonna be something like this one, and you guys supposed to estimate this one. Vertical load. Most of the time, it's come from gravity load. Okay. And then, how about this one? Horizontal load. Where horizontal load come from? Where the horizontal load come from? The wind, right? The rain, those kind of thing. Okay. This one, you got to simplify it. The wind can come any direction, in any angle. Okay. But the most proper one, you just put it in the vertical and horizontal direction using your trigonometrics calculation, okay? And then you do the analysis. If you do the model correct, do the analysis correct, the result of the analysis will be correct. But incorrect analysis result will lead to incorrect design, okay? That's why they put theory of structure and structural analysis before steel design, before reinforced concrete design. Okay, understand that, right? After finish this one, we will start to study the steel design. And later, reinforced concrete design. Why won't they put reinforced concrete design before the steel design? Because steel design is more simple. Reinforced concrete design require knowledge of the concrete and steel to work together. They always order to study about it, but up until now, you guys should be able to design the steel structure based on mechanics of materials, okay? And now, after you do that, okay, there are the design, the finished product of the design going to be the detail, okay, of the structure. For the reinforced concrete, there is a lot of line over here. What is it? This one? Tell me what? This is going to be steel reinforcement. Why they put it in the bottom? Because concrete have low capacity for the tension. So we put more steel in tension size. Okay, and steel can take tension force better than the concrete. There is concept like this one. You guys should understand it. And then when you design it, the strength, remember? The strength, that means the stress occur, this beam should be less than the allowable stress of the steel and allowable stress of the concrete. That means have enough strength. And then stability. After you finish the structure, then you jump it. You can see this fall didn't do the vibration. Okay, they have the stability. Okay, if you decide the slab so thin, when you jump over it, the slab can vibrate a lot. And then that's going to have large deformation and then didn't have a good stability. Now, when you do the design, you got to follow two things. Minimum requirement. Oh, sorry, this is steel in Thai. Minimum requirement of steel code and specification. Okay, you got to follow that. And then now, there are computer program. You are new generation. And it's a good time to start learning about Leavitt. Okay, there are a lot of YouTube teach you. And then you should register for the Autodesk. That is the student license. You can renew it every year. Okay, and then from now on start using downloading a simple structure tying to use the AutoCAD and then using the Revit there are a lot of learning stuff in the YouTube to start and to get used to WizKid now there are also the computer program Pipeng Napai have studied about it SAP 2000 ETAP those kind of thing you may ask Pipeng Napai also and there are a lot of illegal program you may download it for study then when you have work get the money just pay them back later okay and then the important thing after you finish the design analysis correct okay design correct now construction must be correct follow what you have designed in the detail of this one from what you see in the paper going to put in the real world that's going to be very art and science of civil engineering right we didn't like a scientist okay a lot of thing about our construction require skill and that's why you got to do the cooperative education and you're going to be on the third year if possible if not you should go on the fourth year okay now you understand the all the step required for construction of a building first planning right second use analysis okay method third design the structure based on code and specification and then construct the structure following what you have designed any question oh Adam it's like a lecture yes it's a kind of lecture it's very important believe me and this one more important than the detail on the calculation okay and there are a lot of YouTube also you may go searching for the beam what's the beam by the YouTube those kind of thing now let me take you to the classification of the structure first you may classify it by the form second you may classify it by the function most of the time we classify it by the form very important small member that's show over here this one is very small it's only can subjected to the tension okay tensile force but it's important for the stability of the structure if you won't believe it go to F4 building head you up to the roof and you will see the tilt what the function of tilt is help the whole structure to resist the forces such as the wind forces okay without this kind of simple structure if the wind come in this direction the structure can collapse easily very important and the design also very simple but it's important now the second one you know about it the beam okay the beam used to support most of the time the floor okay the load from the floor transfer from the beam something like this one and then the beam usually subjected to transverse load and most of the time it sits in vertical direction and then you can design the beam based on bending moment and transverse shear force that mean we will draw the shear diagram and moment diagram later and then going to the model of the beam there are three important one as I mentioned in the mechanics of material simple supported beam simply supported beam we just call it simple beam the cantilever beam and the overhanging beam and there are also very large long beam this can be called statically indeterminate beam okay and the first part we going to study before the midterm examination and indeterminate we going to be study at the end of the subject and then There are wide flank steel beam, and you should understand that we have the flank to resist the internal moment, and we have the web to resist the shear force. Remember from the mechanics of material, right? And then what we have next is going to be reinforced concrete beam. On the RC beam, again, there is the main reinforcement. Okay, as I mentioned, this one to most of the time to resist the tension. Okay, and then we have this one also called the stirrup. That's for what? For the shear force. That means for the RC beam. For RC beam, the steel may support the tension on the positive bending moment on the bottom. On the top, the concrete and the steel rod, sorry, steel reinforcement gonna take the compression, and then the stirrup gonna taking care of the shear force. And then when you design it, you got to design them separately. Okay, to design for the main reinforcement, to design for the stirrup, this kind of thing. And there are details you can read it by yourself. And then I love the detail of the reinforcement, and I don't know, it's going to be art and science to build it. And up until your generation, you got to be able to use the computer program to detail the reinforcement and column. You know about it, right? To resist the compression, and if the column subjected to compression and bending moment, this one called the column, only compression. But if the column subjected to the compression and the moment, we call it beam column. When you study steel design, column will be in one chapter. And then you also have the beam in one chapter. And then you have the beam column in another chapter. Okay, the design of them different. And following what I'm mentioned, and the designs must based on the design code and based on the design specification. And then after that, you got to use the concept. And then for this step distribution is come from combined loading chapter 8 from the mechanics of material. You're supposed to be able to dock it. Okay, I won't go back and mention about it. And if you prefer, you may go back to my previous year's lecture. And then in the computer program, after you modeling for slash commercial building, okay, Akan Panit commercial building, this is going to be two story and three of them. Okay, you're going to have a more complex distribution of the moment, both in the beam and in the column. And you got to be able to use this moment diagram properly in the design, such as the steel structure. Okay, next course, not this one, but this one, you should be able to plot the diagram. And then the task, everybody learning from the static, the task can be roof task and the bridge task. And you can see the task around here, both roof task and bridge task. And the task, again, I won't go to the detail. I have mentioned about it already. But most of the time, you can see the task made by what? Reinforced concrete or the steel? Steel, most time, okay, due to the form of the task, it's very hard to put the reinforcement and cast the concrete. It's better to use the steel. And then the task used worldwide due to the form of kit. The task also one of very effective and efficiency structure. Okay, is can use in a large span structure, unlike the reinforced concrete beam. Okay, the the span of the structure going to be short. The detail of this one, you may, if you're interested, you may read it later. And if you walk around here, down to the floor in this size of the building, you will see this task. And again, just thinking about it, when you look at the structure, if you prefer a design engineer, you got to feel how the structure, this is the forces. Now, we have the green task I just mentioned. This is near the activities building. And this is the cable. You may go to Bung Ta Lua, okay? And take a look at the cable bridge over there. Have you been there? Okay, you've been there. You may have jogging. There is a lot of people jogging every day over there. Cable also one very effective structure. It can resist very large force. So the span of the cable structure can be very large, larger than 45 meter. And then Bung Ta Lua is over here. Okay, beautiful beach, right? It's over here. And then there is the floor over here. You may walking, passing, took it. Okay. And also, we have cable stair bridge. This one is too complicated. We've been talking about it over here. We're just talking about the suspension bridge, like this one that's used the cable. And then there are arches. I take this picture from Rongrien Nairoy Chopalo, Phat Chulachom Kao Army Academy, okay, in Nakhon Nayok. Okay, that is a huge stadium. And then they put the arch over here. We didn't see much arch structure in Thailand, but if you go abroad, you may see arch as the beast. A lot of them in the US and in the Europe. In Thailand, we prefer to use concrete to build the bridge, okay? But that is not as one in the US. They use intensively the steel structure. And then the frame. You know, where is it? If you're building the old one, old activities building, you may go over there thinking about it. Take a look at this one. It's going to be fixed. It's going to be the pin or it's going to be the roller. Let's thinking about it. How they connect part of this column to this beam, how the load transfer from the top to the bottom, those kind of things. As the engineer, thinking systematically like that. And then how everything connected to each other. And the second picture is like a frame of the bridge. Okay, we have the frame of the building and then we have the frame of the bridge. Now, we have a lot of frame, okay? And again, can be built by the steel and built by the reinforced concrete and built by the pre-stressed concrete whatsoever. And following this one, have you visit the structure like this one? Again, old activities building in front of it. Now, I should say, you guys should be able to analyze and design it, even construct it. But before you can analyze it, you got to thinking about the structure. You got to do the planning, how tall it's going to be, okay? How cover length is supposed to be, right? And then how the load's going to act on the structure, how the wind broke it, how to convert the wind into the forces act on the structure. You got to know that, right? Before you can analyze it. Because now the problem is in your hand. No one, no ajahn, got to give you the loads act up on the structure. You got to do the load transfer. We got to talking about this in next, okay, step on chapter one and chapter two. But anyway, after finish that one, we just let you guys be able to know how to estimate the load, right? From chapter three, we just say talking about the task. Chapter four, talking about the frame or the beam, ajahn will provide you with the information. If not, if you estimate the load wrong, the result will be wrong. Okay, that is no good. That's why ajahn gonna provide you. You got the same load. And then after analyzing the structure, you got the same result. Now, let's go to about it. How about this one? academic building one. Okay, on the top cockpit. This one have something like this one. The hallway have on the left and on the right side, but this one have only one side. What a different? The function different, the model different. Okay, and now the surface structure. A lot of stadium have that roof surface structure, and also have the tent structure. Okay, that's I'm talking about the structure. Any question? You can link it by yourself for sure, and you can search it. They search on the YouTube also. I start with half an hour it, so I got to finish this one, chapter one, as much as I can. But by the meantime, any question? No question. Let's talking about the second important thing. We have structure already. How about the loads? There are building code. That is the legal document that you guys gonna follow it. Okay. This building code in Thailand, okay, specified by the Ministry of Interior. And most of the time, the Council of Engineers Thailand have the duty to develop the building code. And it's going to be the minimum design load, the analysis and design regulation and the requirement for the construction standard. We didn't talking about this one in our SUT. During my time, we have the course of what's so called law, contract, and specification. When you build anything, okay, when you do the bidding of the structure, you got the structure cost 5 million baht. You got to declare everything, both materials, labor, machine, those kind of thing, and put it the number and do the bidding. Who can do a good estimation, okay, can get the bidding, and then you are the winner of the contract. Okay, you got to build the structure basis upon that. Anyway, the structure must, in any country, must be analyzed and designed basis upon this one. And then there are very important, I call it important because the Bangkok building code is going to be the modern building code. But for the typical Kot Kasuang, that's going to be very old. Okay. And the second one, we're talking about the design code. The design code is not the legal document, but is developed by professional organization such as what in Thailand. I mentioned about this one already. I said building code most of the time developed by Council of Engineer Thailand. How about this one? That is the second one. The EIT, okay, Engineering Institute of Thailand. Okay, most of the time, Ajahn in the university are the member in this EIT organization. And then when the country such as Japan or America have a new version of the design code, most of Ajahn gonna head-to-head together, what should we modify our code? But most of the time, it takes like 5 or 10 years to develop the design code. But it's going to be very important document, okay? Because this design code can revise easily, unlike the building code, that's legal stuff. And then when the new design code come, you may get the allowable to work on it, okay? And AICI is going to be American Concrete Institute. This one called ASTO, American Association of the State and Highway Transportation Organization. Very long word, but important one. AISC, this one, you're going to use it in the steel design. This one, you got to use it in the reinforces concrete 1 and the reinforces concrete 2. Actually, that is the PCI. The PCI. The PCI. Pre-stressed Concrete Institute. That's for the pre-stressed concrete. Okay, with Ajahn Anup. That's going to be in the fourth year. Okay. Now, let me put it into first simple one. Okay. Talking about our weight. Okay. Our weight. We have the weight. This morning, I weighed myself. It's 80.7 kilogram. Okay. That's called self-weight. Since the structure won't move, unlike me, and move around, okay, I'm not a dead load. Okay, and the life load, I'll be talking about later. Dead load is the load of the structural member that would move, such as the weight of the floor, the weight of the beam, the weight of the column. And then for the dead load, it's going to be the permanent load act on structure. So you got to use the density of the material to estimate the dead load. Okay, which one is the heaviest? Which one is the heaviest? It's going to be steel, okay? And then the second, reinforces concrete. The third, brick, right? And then the timber, okay? And then there is various things. This one, we put it in structural form. Not in the material form, this one per cubic meter, this one in the structural form, we put it in square meter, such as you see the silver color over there, that is going to be roofing materials. Okay, that's going to weigh 50 to 180 kilo. I think it's wrong. There's something wrong. It's going to be point. It's going to be like a 5 to 18 Newton, 50 to 180 Newton. Should be only this one per square meter. Okay. The ceiling is over here. Ceiling, right? This one called ceiling, right? Okay. The ceiling can be 0.14 to 0.25 kilonewton per square meter. That's the dead load. Ajahn, how I choose it? There is the length of it. You got to prove it. Okay, if you weren't sure, just select this material, put it on the scale and use it. Okay, if not sure. But most of the time there are specifications, the manual. Okay, just follow the manual. You can estimate it. And then example, okay, there is a beam over here, right? And the beam over here have this section, and then the weight of the beam with constant section will provide uniformly distributed load. Now, we have the material, including the concrete and the steel reinforcement. Since the load is uniformly distributed load, the unit of it gonna be kilonewton per meter, right? So when you compute it, you got to compute this one by the length of 1 meter, okay? And then if you compute this 1 meter, it's going to cover this load on the structure. Now, how to compute it? Use the density of the materials, okay? Now, basis on this one per 1 meter, per 1 meter, we will compute for the beam cross section, okay? The beam cross section include what? Include this one we call, this is the flank, right? This is the flank, right? And what the dimension of the flank? It's gonna be 0.1. And this is 0.2, 0.2, 0.4. This is gonna be 0.55 meter, right? And then there is the web, this one. We call it the web, okay? And the web, however, this one is what? This width, 0.15, and this is 0.4. So you can compute for the whole total section of the beam. And then there is the section of the beam. This is the total area. Okay. This is 0.1 times 0.55. Okay. And then we have this one, 0.15 times 0.4. And then time meter. Okay. This is going to be 0.115 cubic meter per length of beam. Now there is the steel. Okay. There are steel over there. There is the, oh, they didn't include the steel. Self-weight of the RC beam. Okay. They include the reinforced concrete approximately already. Okay. That's one. If you go over here, you don't need to do the steel reinforcement for this one. Just go and use this number, reinforced concrete. Okay. And then you may approximate the weight of this one, just this one, the volume 1 meter. And then this is going to be 23.6 from the table, kilonewton per cubic meter. You get the weight of 2.714 kilonewton per meter. Very simple, right? Very simple. But in the building, there are 20 beams. You got to calculate it many times for this one. Okay. Now, when I put this one over there, let's set it 2.71 on this overhanging beam. Next, how can you compute for the reaction? Hey, simple, Ajahn, engineering static. I studied about it already. How can you compute order the shear diagram and moment diagram? Oh, simple, Ajahn. I got the A from in static. Very simple. How can you determine the deflection? Hey, mechanics of material can do so. No, this beam, we didn't study it in the mechanics of material. We study only simple beam. Now, that's why subject, you got to study how to determine the deflection for this kind of beam. Okay. And then there is the thing that you guys should be able to, I ask you to go back and do the calculation and check with this reaction, shear diagram, moment diagram, this one later, after we go to chapter 8, you should be able to determine the free friction. Go back, what I'm assigned, just for your practice, okay? And then what we have kit, we use a lot of simple beam nowadays, especially if you work in the highway construction. This is precast, prestressed concrete beam. During the construction of the foundation of the pier, of the cross beam, that is the construction of the beam in factories. And then the beam shipped by Mercedes-Benz, this is not shipped by this one, the 18 wheeler, those kind of thing. And then we have this one, the crane, to lift it and install it. Okay. Every country, no matter you come from Myanmar, Cambodia, Philippines, this kind of construction very popular nowadays because it's simple. Okay. You don't need to do it on the side. You may use two precasts in a factory and chip it. The quality of the beam also good for that. And then for next example, now we have on your hand. Okay. You have what? You have the beam. Now, your beam is what? The prestressed concrete girder made by plain stone concrete and four, 19 millimeter cold form steel reinforcing rod. The steel reinforcing pre-stressed rod, this one high strength steel, usually is have the yielding strength of 1,200 megapascal, four, five times higher than the typical mild steel. Okay. Now they ask us to determine the dead load of this one, the dead weight of the girder per meter. Just put it only the cross section, right? Now, you can separate, okay? If you guys go to my previous lecture, I put it in some different thing, okay? This time, my calculation gonna depend on how do you separate the section. Let me put this one, okay? Let me put this one of the middle portion, okay? And then this is what? For 1 meter, for 1 meter, you can compute for the cross sectional area, okay? Let me put this one area for 1 meter. We just calculate for the area of plain concrete, of concrete, of the concrete, okay? The first portion of this one gonna be what? You got to read this section. The width of this one is what? 0.15, right? So this one, 0.15. And then the height of this one gonna be 0.2, okay? Plus 0.15. And then this one you may time by 2 and then plus 0.50. This is going to be the yellow area, right? Okay, yellow area. And then there are the other area, okay? The area over here. This is going to be the red area. This also the red area, and also this one the red area, and this one also the red area. So plus 4 times what? 4 times what? This is 0.1. This is 0.2. Okay, so it's gonna be 4 times of 0.1, and then 0.2. Okay, and then there is the triangle. Okay, there is triangle 1, 2, 3, and then 4 plus 4. Okay, time 1/2. This is gonna be 0.1, and the height 0.15. That's going to be the total of the area. If you compute it, the first one you got to have 0.1, sorry, 8, and then plus the other. Okay, and then you get this one for the whole section. Not correct. I forgot about the steel. Okay. If we compute the concrete, we got to have the total area subtract by the cross section of the concrete. Oh, sorry, cross section of the steel. Okay. Let me move you to this one. This is too fast. The area of steel. Area of steel is what? We have 4, right? 4, okay. 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then time pi, and then this is gonna be 0.0019 diameter divided by 2, and then square. Okay, and then you should get this one to be 1.1134 10 - 3 square meter. Okay, so for this one, I forgot. Ajahn choose minus. Okay, this one 1.1314 10. Minus 3, okay, and then Ajahn should get the area of the concrete after that. this one. I should get the area of the concrete, right? I got to subtract that one by the steel, and then I should get the area of the concrete to be 0.288866. You see a lot of significant figure, okay? And then this is going to be square meter. Now, we have two materials. One is the concrete, and this is going to be plain stone concrete. This plain stone concrete, 22.6 kilonewton per cubic meter. This one different from the concrete reinforced stone. Okay, this one is heavier because it's estimate the steel inside the concrete already. This is only the plain. Oh, now what we have it. The second is going to be the steel from the table. This one is the minimum, okay, density from the steel. What we have is this one steel, okay, core form or core door is going to be equivalent. This is going to be 77.3. Now, what we have is what's going to be the weight of this one, which is going to be estimate the weight. The weight going to be uniformly distributed load is going to be W, and the unit of this one going to be kilonewton per meter, right? So W is going to be 0.288866. 0.288866 square meter, and then time 22.6 kilonewton per cubic meter. That's for the concrete, right? And then there is the steel. Okay, you just put it over here. So plus 1.1 3 4 10 minus 3 square meter, and then time over here 77.3 kilonewton per cubic meter. So the result gonna be in kilonewton per meter. The first one you should get this one equal to what? 6.528, right? And then for the steel, what you get? 0.088. Okay, and then the total of this one gonna be 6.616 kilonewton per meter. Okay. And then if you have the beam, okay, the beam, you got to have the weight of this one, right? And then this is going to be the beam have the W, okay, of 6.616 kilonewton per meter. And the beam is going to be 20 meter long, okay? What's going to be the total weight of this one, the capital W? Just put 6.616 kilonewton per meter time 20 meter, and then you will get the total weight copied. Okay, is this important? Why not? Go to the pictures of the beam. You got to use the crane to lift it, right? Okay, then you got to know about it. Okay, what the number of kit? I didn't put kit. Do what you get? 132.31 kilonewton. Is that some more? That's going to be a huge number, right? Okay, that's going to be like 113.23 ton. Okay, and then when you
when you got to work on this one, like lifting this one, okay, you guys supposed to be able to design the cable. If this one is 132.31, each cable supposed to resist half of that, right? Okay, now you guys should be able to design the cable. Now you are engineer, right? You can work as a highway engineer to install the beam into the position. But actually, you're going to use 132.31 exact number. No, usually we got to overestimate for the safety, right? And when you design it, you got to have 2 or 3 factor of safety for the cable. Any question? Okay, this is maybe the first examination problem. We have 2 examples already. Now, let me move you to the next one. There is the wall, okay, put on the floor and have the plaster. Then we like to determine the net load of the wall, the floor, and the plaster that's applied to the beam. We didn't thinking about the beam, okay? We just neglected. We're talking about the wall. And then following this one, the material used to build it different. For the concrete masonry unit, this is going to be the unit, okay? And we're going to compute it for 1 meter, okay? And this is going to be the volume of the CMU, concrete masonry unit. And then we have the reinforced concrete. This is 10 centimeter, okay? And it's gonna be 1 meter long also. And then we may compute the weight of it. And then the plaster is gonna be the back. Now, the plaster ceiling is a kind of structure. So it's going to be the weight per watt per square meter different from the CMU and different from the RC slab. Now, for the RC slab, okay, the green and then time the thickness, that's going to be 2 meter. Where is 2 meter, Achan? The 2 meter is going to be this one. This is going to be 2 meter, okay? And then for per 1 meter, this is going to be 1 meter. And then the thickness over here going to be 0.1 meter. So for a meter, that we do the consideration for the concrete slab, it's going to be 4.72. Now we move to the concrete. Sorry, with the ceiling is the black, okay? We didn't have the thickness of the ceiling, but the ceiling is 2 meter over here and 1 meter over here, okay? Time 0.2 kilonewton per square meter. So the weight of the ceiling on the 1 meter beam is gonna be 0.4. And then the wall. Now the wall is the yellow one. Okay, what we have is going to compute for the volume cockpit. The thickness of this one is going to be 0.3. The height is going to be 2.5, okay, for 1 meter of the wall. And then you can see that's going to be the weight of the wall, the slab, and the plaster act upon the beam. Now, the summation cockpit going to be 19.32 kilonewton per meter. Okay, not include the beam yet. Okay, not include the weight of the beam yet. How to include the weight of the beam? If you know the beam over here to be, for example, W200 times 49, this is going to be the section, that Y flank section, okay, have this one for 200 millimeter approximately, and the weight cockpit gonna be 49 kilogram per meter. Just change it to kilonewton and plus it to 19.32. So you're going to get all the uniformly distributed load act up on the beam. Okay, if they're interested in that one, but for 19.32, only for wall, slab, and the sailing. And then what we have for next one, we have the next one. This one is the wall. The wall is 2.5 meter high. And then it consists of the stud. I should say it consists of the stud. The stud is over here. Stud is the kind of the timber. Okay, over here and over here. And also have this one. So this structure called stud. Okay. And then the stud, what's so called in Thai? In Thai, called kong khao. Okay. In English, we call stud. Stud is just the light blue. And then there is the brick, in front cockpit. The brick over there is going to be 102 millimeter cubic. You know about this one, right? This is going to be the cubic over here, And then there is what? There is the fiberboard. Fiberboard is on another side to put it over here. One side is the fiberboard. Another side is the brick. Okay. Like this one is one is going to be fiberboard. Not like this one. This is big. Actually, this is the big. And then there is the stud. Okay. And then there is the fiberboard. This kind of structure uses in Western country because it's cold over there. So there is the wall, egg wall, and then the stud. Stud had the air gap. Okay. The air gap is going to prevent the cold weather to come to the structure. And then there is a fiberboard. And then what's going to be the force causing by the structure act up on the floor? That's going to support the wall. We are estimating this tabulot for 1 meter due to three types of brick, of stud, and of the fiberboard. Now, where is it? There is always the table. Okay, what we have over here. Let me check for my solution. I didn't bring it over here anyway. Okay, for the stud, okay, we got to have this one for the roof stud, right? This is going to be what we have, okay, 51 times 102 stud over here, plaster on one side, the plaster on one side. That's going to be 0.57 kilonewton per square meter. And then there is the fiberboard. Okay, fiberboard is going to be the yellow one. What is going to be the fiberboard? Can you see me? This is going to be the fiberboard. Okay, right? This is going to be the fiberboard. That is 0.04 kilonewton per square meter. And what else do we have? How thick it is? 102 is going to be this one for 1.87. Okay, based upon this, we may call it for clay brick. For clay brick, what we have is going to be the W, okay, is going to be, let's say, W1. It's going to be the area. This is for 1 meter. This is for 1 meter. And the height of this one is 2.5. So it's going to be 2.5 meter times 1 meter. And this one going to be 1.87 kilonewton per square meter. So W1 is going to be 4.675, okay, kilonewton for 1 meter. Okay, this one for 1 meter. 1 meter of the wall. And then we have the second one. That's for the fiberboard. Okay, we have the fiberboard. For fiberboard. Okay, we have what? We have this one. That's going to be 1 meter and 2.5 meter. Again, we have W2. 2.5 meter and 1 meter. We have this one, 0.04 kilonewton per square meter. And this is for the length of 1 meter. We have this one, 0.1 kilonewton per meter. Second. Third, we have what? We have the stud, okay? Now we have the stud, the same calculation for stud. For stud, we have what? W3. That is going to be 2.5 meter, 1 meter. And then we have this one, 0.57 kilonewton square meter. And then we got this one, 1.4 to 5 kilonewton per meter. So the sum of them, we have W. Okay. Therefore, W is going to be the total sum of this one. Approximately, we have this is 6.20 kilonewton per meter. Okay. That's going to be slapped on the ground floor. Okay, that's going to be the slab on the ground floor. You can compute this one. Now, okay, let you guys write on this first. Very simple, right? Very simple. Kilonewton, yeah. Oh. You mean what? You mean where this come from? For 1 meter width, okay, of the wall, we calculate per meter is uniformly distributed load. Okay, for 1 meter length of the wall. Why? W is uniformly distributed load. All the way, it's gonna be down here for 1 meter. It's uniformly distributed load. The concept, like the wall over here, is going to be the lie load. Okay, the lie load can apply on the floor. The lie load can apply from the beam. Okay, most of the time we prefer to have the beam to support the wall, but many times this called lightweight wall. Okay, sometimes if it's lightweight wall, won't have brick. It is the same wall as I have in my office over this picture over here. Okay, this size of my office. Okay, it is the fiberboard on the left and on the right, and there is the stud made by lightweight steel. This is the lightweight. Okay, this kind of lightweight you don't need to put it on the beam. Okay, because it's lightweight. But this one by the brick, this one, there is the column over here, so that is the beam. So you got to put the masonry wall on the beam. But for light
weight wall, you may put it on the wall. Okay, depend on the application of this one.This is not the material consideration. I said on the dead load, there is two things. The red portion. Sometimes we got to consider it based on the type of materials. But this one is ceiling, is big, massively. Okay, this is a kind of structure. Use the brick in massively. This is theSailing, okay, something like this one. Different from this one, sometimes we got to consider the materials, okay, depend on the problem, depend on the problem. Okay, now you're supposed to be able to estimate the dead load, right? Okay, let me move you a bit to finish our problem. Now, there is theload that change both magnitude and location, such as the weight of our student. Okay, you come, you are live load, finish the class, you out. Okay, you move. Okay, next class, the location you sit down may be different, so it can change. Okay, both of the magnitude and the location, it can be theStudent weight in the classroom, it can be the wind load, okay? And then for the building code, okay, there is the live load for the roof. On the construction of the roof, there is the worker clamp over there. You got to estimate it at the live load. Pecho, and then for the kindergarten, okay, bathroom and the restroom is 1.5 kilonewton per square meter. However,If it is the university, since you guys is bigger than the children in the kindergarten, so the life load gonna be larger and two times larger. Okay, and then following this one, there are various load distribution, both lead load and life load on the structure. And for this one, there is an example over here. The last one.We have the floor with the light, floor with the light storage warehouse. This is storage warehouse. And then for the light storage warehouse, there is the specified light load over here. Okay. And also, this is going to be the light load, the light storage warehouse made by.The floor, okay, that is going to be this kind of floor, 3 meter over here, 7 meter over here, and this is going to have the floor with the thickness of 0.15 meter, okay, then they ask us to.Determine the uniformly distributed force caused by the net load and the live load. Now, for the floor, the distributed load gonna be in unit of what? Unit of W, unit of equal to anything to square meter, because in reality, the weight applied to the floor will cover all the area.Will cover all the area, okay? Over here, both the dead load and live load. You guys see anything about this, right? There is a slab, okay? The weight distribute all over it. And there is two things. One is going to be live load, okay? This is gonna be 6.0.Kilonewton per square meter. Very simple. Take it from the table. Depend on type of the structure. Okay. And then there is the dead load per square meter of the concrete. This is going to be 1 meter. This is going to be
1 meter and this is going to be 0.15. So we have the dead load equal to for this one equal to what? Equal to what? This is concrete, right? And then the land forces concrete. You have this one for 23.6 kilonewton per cubic meter. Go back to the dead load that I just mentioned. And then for the volume of this area, okay, 1 square meter, right? Right? It's going to be time one and time 0.15. Okay. Could you put it for me? How do we get it? It's going to be 3.54, right? Right? Kilonewton. And then that is cover for a square meter. So the total that we have going to be the combination of the life load and dead load. So what we have over here is going to be W equal to 6 plus 3.54. That is going to be 9.54 kilonewton per square meter. And then total weight, okay, total W is going to be 9.54 kilonewton per square meter times 3 meter times 7 meter. That's going to be 203.34 kilonewton. This one you may study about it later. We call it slab on ground. Okay, and slab on ground is using in the construction of F4 and F5. Okay, to time out, there are students in front of us. Okay, and we will come back next Thursday morning.